Hey, are you feeling tired right now? Don't worry, we all feel tired from time to time. Feeling tired on a regular basis is extremely common. In fact, about 1/3 of healthy teens, adults, and older individuals report feeling sleepy or fatigued. Fatigue is a common symptom of several conditions and serious diseases, but in most cases, it is simply caused by lifestyle factors. Fortunately, you are in control of your lifestyle, and therefore you can fix certain things in your life that drain all your energy, or you can break certain habits that do you more harm than good. So let's take a look at what you can do to get rid of your tiredness and how you can boost your energy levels. The first thing you can do to boost your energy levels is to increase your daily water intake. The Institute of Medicine recommends for men a total of 13 cups, that's about 3 liters of fluid each day. For women, they suggest 9 cups, that's about a little over 2 liters of fluid each day. Note that I said fluid and not water. Fluid can be anything, ranging from alcohol to soda and juices. These types of drinks have its place in life, and although they taste well and give you a nice energy boost, it's a short-term fix and not a sustainable way to increase your energy. Your body weight is about 60% made of water and not soda. The science is clear on the effects of water. It boosts your energy levels, maximizes physical performance, and it prevents crankiness and headaches. When you drink water, you replenish your stores. Without enough water, your body and its organs can't function properly. There are many different opinions on how much water you should be drinking every day. Health authorities commonly recommend 8 8-ounce glasses, which equals about 2 liters or half a gallon. This is called the 8x8 rule, and it's very easy to remember, though there's no real science behind this rule to support its claim. The truth is, how much water you need as an individual depends on how active you are and what type of climate you live in and many other personal circumstances. The best thing you can do is to make water your primary source of the recommended daily fluid intake, and you will start to notice within a short period of time an increase in your energy levels. The second tip is to break bad sleeping habits and to increase the quality of your sleep. Not getting enough sleep is one of the more obvious causes of fatigue. Your body does many things while you sleep, including storing memory and releasing hormones that regulate your energy levels. After a night of high quality sleep, you typically wake up feeling refreshed, alert, and energized. According to scientific research, adults need an average of 7 hours of sleep per night for optimal health. Studies show that you increase the quality of your sleep by going to bed during the weekdays and the weekends at the same time, being physically active during the day, avoiding highly energizing meals 2 hours before you go to sleep, and by minimizing the exposure to bright screens 1 hour before you go to bed, because this disrupts the production of the hormone melatonin. Your brain secretes more melatonin when it's dark, making you sleepy, and less when it's light, making you more alert. So when you wake up after a good night of sleep and feeling energized, the biggest question is, how can I stay energized throughout the day? Well, you should start off your day with a healthy breakfast. It's quite literally the meal meant to quote-unquote break the fast from all the hours you spend sleeping. One of the most common reasons people skip breakfast is because they're just not hungry in the morning, or that they don't have the time to eat something. Studies show that your blood sugar drops, which leaves you feeling overly hungry, cranky, and fatigued. Furthermore, your stress hormone skyrockets, which can make you feel anxious and agitated. So make time for a healthy meal in the morning. A healthy breakfast consists of complex carbohydrates, fiber, and a decent amount of protein. Complex carbs take longer to break down by the body than simple carbs, so your body can use the nutrients throughout the day, which contrasts with simple carbs, since they cause a spike in your sugar levels, because they are very easy to break down, and so they give you a quick energy boost. However, what goes up fast comes even faster down, but as a result feeling cranky and tired. So just eating something for the sake of eating something after you wake up is not the smartest way to go about it. You should also consider the quality of your breakfast to get the most out of it. So the next tip might not be as easy to implement as the others. It's about stress and how it drains your energy both physically and mentally. Stress causes your muscles to tense up, ready to leap into action. The body uses a lot of energy to keep the muscles in that tense state, and if they stayed away for too long, they are going to get tired. You will find your whole body feels drained. On a mental level, stress affects your brain activity. Your brain is highly alert and trying to process all those thoughts and messages. All that activity is just as draining as physical exertion. So it's no wonder that you feel mentally exhausted from stress. Stress is not something you can simply fix. There's no magic solution to the problems that cause you stress, though there are definitely some ways to manage your stress better. One of the ways is meditation. The research is very clear on the benefits to your mental health. You don't need to sit and meditate for 1 hour straight. You can enjoy the benefits with meditation exercises that only take 15 minutes. It can really help change the way you approach life. Another way is by reducing the responsibility you take on in your life. The truth of the matter is that you are responsible for yourself and nobody else. This might sound harsh, but this is called setting boundaries. Furthermore, you will definitely see a reduction in stress if you implement the tips I already mentioned in this video. Since the research shows that stress has a strong negative association to the quality of these variables as well, which means that, for example, if you drink more water, you're able to manage your stress better, or that when you sleep better, you will feel less stressed. The final big reason why you always feel tired could be because of our sedentary lifestyle. A sedentary lifestyle is defined as a type of lifestyle where an individual does not receive regular amounts of physical activity. We've become more sedentary than 50 years ago. According to the World Health Organization, 60 to 85% of the population worldwide does not engage in enough activity. To make it even worse, physical inactivity is the fourth leading risk factor for death in the world. Okay, you may not die, but I want you to realize that if you're not engaging in enough physical activity, that you're not alone, and that more people suffer from physical inactivity. When tiredness sets in, sitting on the couch and relaxing could seem like it's the only answer, but getting up and moving may be the best thing you can do to re-energize and to overcome your fatigue. The science is clear on this. You will feel much more energized once you exercise on a consistent basis. The explanation for this goes deep into the cellular level of the body, where we find the mitochondria, those tiny energy-producing organs found in every cell of the body. The more you move around, the more mitochondria your body makes to meet your energy needs. The more mitochondria you have, the greater the boost to your metabolism and the greater your ability becomes to produce more energy. This impacts other biological mechanisms as well. Your aerobic capacity increases, allowing you to deliver more oxygen to your brain and bloodstream, and your blood will circulate more efficiently, which causes increased functioning throughout your whole body. As a general goal, aim for at least 30 minutes of physical activity every day. This can be strength or cardio training. Scientists have concluded that exercising more and not less is the key to overcoming tiredness. So come on, get your ass off the couch and start working out. So in sum, I understand that everybody's tiredness is caused by unique reasons. Maybe your tiredness has multiple causes, or maybe not. Maybe there's only one cause. I mentioned these 5 variables in this video because their effects are scientifically supported and because of my own experience on how I dealt with feeling tired all the time. So improve yourself where needed on these variables and you will definitely see improvements in your energy levels. With that said, thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up.